接下来请收看慈悲的眼睛。行善而不希望回报，甚至不执着善名和我在行善，才是真正懂行善的人。
In case good deed is done with no expectation for returns in kind, no clinging for celebrity recognition and egotistic preoccupation of my good deeds,It is then deemed a person of benevolence who truly comprehends the practice of wholesome deeds.
要永远记住，生命的敌人绝不是在外面，而是我们内在的占有欲，不甘愿与我执，就是由这些负面的情绪与力量，才会使我们感到不如意与逆境等等。因此，调整我们的心态吧。
We must always remember that our enemies in life are not external, but rather are our internal possessiveness, discontentment, and egoism. These negative emotions and forces cause us to experience discouragement and obstructions. So let's adjust our mindset.
都是自己生命的主宰，所以当我们遭怨敌加害或受再大的挫败时，千万别再将过错指向他人。当我们清楚了解因果不虚的道理之后，将能明理地面对生命中的不顺遂。
As we are our own master in life, therefore, when subjected to torments from our bitter foes, or suffered even more severe losses, be that as it may, let's not once again finger pointing at others for the faults. Only if we clearly comprehend the essence of cause and effect beforehand, then we will become sensible in dealing with the setbacks encountered in our life.
生活的目的就是为了散播慈悲以及佛陀的法音，活着就是为了修行，就是为了推动道德良知以及佛陀正法，这才是生活的目的，也是一种责任。
The goals of life are to propagate compassion and the Buddha's Dharma. The purpose of living is for cultivation, the promotion of ethical morality, and the Buddha's righteous Dharma. Such are the goals and responsibilities in life.
一个非佛教徒的素食者，我们也可以了解到，他必然是个不愿为自己口腹之欲而伤害动物的人，一个连动物都不肯伤害的人，当然是一个有爱心、尊重生活的人。
We can gather that even a non-Buddhist vegetarian must not be one willing to harm animals for comestible desires. One who is unwilling to harm even animals is clearly a person with a kind heart and respect for life.
心改变了，世界就改变了。你希望世界好，就要从心做起，这叫心灵环保。你希望国家社会更好，就不要再一直批评了。你把自己的心态调整好，有爱心、平静，事情就会变得圆满。
When it comes to the world, it's no exception to the truth of mind over matter. If you wish for a better world, the place to start is your mental makeup. That is to say, sustainable development of positive mental state. If you desire good progress for the nation and the society, then stop constant bickering, fine-tune your mental makeup. Be caring and peaceful.It will turn out all's well that ends well.
自己做功德，要一直回向别人。别人做功德，我们随喜。这样做能扩大我们的功德和心量，永远把握这个原则。
We should be perpetually dedicating our meritorious virtues to others. When others are developing meritorious virtues, we should rejoice over their actions. By doing this, we can amplify our meritorious virtues and broaden our mindset.Always keep this principle in mind.
如果能够纯粹为了利他， 为了正法的传播，尽心尽力，不掺杂一丝一毫的自私心态，我们就是真正在实践菩萨道。
We are truly practicing the Bodhisattva path when we pour our entire heart and effort into the propagation of Dharma, for the sole purpose of benefiting others, undefiled by even a minuscule bit of selfish attitude.
If we only see the way, live by Buddha's law each day, and be one in promoting blessedness. If our hearts are filled with kindness to compassion and care, Buddha's joy will share. Rise up, be like the dewdrop that gives up its individuality and slips into the sea where it can be free. Let's be one in Buddha's call, seek enlightenment for all, rise above all pains and miseries. Take the noble eightfold way, live by Buddha's law each day. Fill our hearts with true love and compassion.
Cha cha, 你的福德存折，这是我们每天都应该省思的课题。这将让你跳脱专注于自身的立场，而去思考散播利益，福泽给他人。
A scheduled topic which we should be reflecting upon daily should be the check-in of our virtuous merit account balance. By doing this, you can break free from being focused on your own point of view and be thinking of spreading benefit and fortune to others.
修行可以让我们修出谦虚，修出包容，修出慈悲，修出智慧，修出光明的人生，修出清净的心灵，修出欢喜的心情，更可修出一辈子的感恩。
Buddha's practice will have our humbleness within brought out, forbearance expanded, compassion amplified, wisdom developed, bright future realized, purified mind instituted, joyful spirit vitalized, and heartfelt gratitude initiated.
培养慈悲心不能只停留在想象或愿望之中，应该因而产生责任感，真正有意担当帮助有情众生离苦得乐的任务。
When it comes to the nurture of compassion, don't stop short at inspiration or aspiration onlyLet it develop into a keen sense of responsibility, by which one willingly endeavors to lift the pains of and to give the joy to all sentient beings.
佛教的功德是弃绝恶行，当我们戒恶时，就不再继续造业了。没有苦时就有平静，平静的心是清洁的心，无嗔清明。
The meritorious virtues in Buddhism are to discard and eradicate vile deeds. When we cease evil doing, then we are no longer creating unwholesome karma. When there is no more suffering, then there is tranquility and peace. A peaceful, serene mind is a pure mind with clarity and without anger.
我们的善行果报会带来幸福与安宁，所以功德是幸福、如意、喜乐、愉悦的同义词。
The results of our wholesome actions will bring forth felicity and peacefulness. Therefore, meritorious virtues are synonymous with felicity, rich fulfillment, joyful happiness.And blissful delight.
尽心尽力为社会、为大众去造福，你真正积德修福，你的一切自然有佛菩萨照顾，有护法神照顾，比你自己照顾周到得多。
Put forth your best and utmost effort to create prosperity for society and for all people.If you are genuinely accumulating virtue and cultivating merit, then your entirety will be looked after by the Buddhas, Bodhisattvas, and virtuous Dharma protector deities with more care and consideration than you can ever provide.
想要过一个有智慧的生活，最重要的任务就是放下。放下是通往自由的路径，唯有放下所有的期望、惧、痛、过去和萦绕心头的事端，让心思安静下来，才能打开心灵之门。
In order to live a life of wisdom, the most important enterprise is to let go. The path towards freedom begins with letting go. The only way to a tranquil mind and opening of the doors to the soul is to let go of all the expectations, fears, agonies, antecedents, and intertwined vexing thoughts encumbering the mind.
He says that life is such a sorrow too,
各位菩萨阿弥陀佛，最近世界上各个角落，包括我们台湾，各位都看到这么多的天灾人祸，甚至有很多人忧郁症乃至自杀。为什么？这就是我们人类的心贪心嗔心所造的恶业，特别是杀生的恶业。每个人对这个世界都要有责任，佛教讲缘起法都有关系。所以希望各位最近多吃素，不要吃肉，多念佛，以慈悲心去做各种的修行，多放生，多施食超度，来回向整个世界，这个才是慈悲的责任。阿弥陀佛。
慈悲仁爱能成就一切善行德业，戒杀吃素能化解世间刀兵瘠疫。中华护生协会慈悲的道路与您一同前行，护持账号42138483，42138483，户名中华护生协会。
大家好，欢迎收看今天的百事达。近来心思无法安宁，自从接触地藏经到现在超过半年了，每每念经时仍有许多妄念，令我觉得念经是一件痛苦的事。请问师父，要如何设法专心念经？怎么专心才好？
谁都想专心了，但是如果你业障重就专心不了啊，所以首先要忏悔消业障，第二个要持戒。既然要诵大乘经典，就要守五戒吃素比较相应。当然进一步各位修十善业，进一步如果念大乘经典还要发菩提心啊，这样来读诵经典那功德更大。
曾听过无数种消业障的方法，想请问师父，每天忏悔可以消业障吗？
当然可以，恶业唯一的价值就是拿来忏悔。所以各位呢，你自己跪下来忏悔啊，诵经忏悔啊，念八十八佛，念三昧水忏忏悔啊，都可以。
那如果我没有吃素，念地藏经有用吗？
都有用，只是念久自然会吃素更好。
假如我诵经忏悔也没有感应的话，该怎么办？
因缘成熟就有感应，但是你念经一定有念经的福报功德消业障，这是100%，这一点一点都不要怀疑，这个非常重要哦。
师父，刚您有提到要发菩提心来诵经，想请问什么是菩提心呢？
因为观察到体悟到众生的各种的痛苦，而发起的每一种痛苦都让佛菩萨升起大悲心，有烦恼他所有这些佛菩萨就针对烦恼而发起的一个大悲心，愿解决乃至承担众生的痛苦。那要就近能够帮助众生，所以你一定要成佛，那叫菩提心。 所以从一开始的大悲发起了愿成佛的菩提心，那你从菩提心到成佛，那叫三大阿僧祇劫。所以一句话，每一个佛从因地发起菩提心，然后一直到最后成佛，这个过程就是消业障，累积成佛的各种的资粮。
无论是忏悔、吃素，还是持戒诵经，都是长养悲心的展现，让我们学习广发菩提心。今天的问题你也理解了吗？谢谢师父今天为我们解答。海涛法师百事达，我们下期见，拜。
印经功德殊胜行，无边胜福皆回向，普愿成溺诸众生，速往无量光佛刹，十方三世一切佛，一切菩萨摩诃萨，摩诃般若波罗蜜。